Hi, so we already have discussed the initial concepts regarding the band model and how we represent band model while discussing semiconductor physics. So it's like EC, then you have valence band, you have energy band gap. The bottom of valence band can be represented as EB, and the top of conduction band can be ET. Then you have a vacuum level E0. Okay, so we represent each state as a straight line. Okay, so in this case, I mean in this lecture, I'll cover first the distribution of allowed states over the energy. Now, to begin with, I would like to recap the band model that we have already discussed. So you have vacuum level, you have conduction band, and you have valence band. So this EV is the top edge of the valence band, and EC is the bottom edge of the conduction band, and then you have a band gap in the middle. So the discussion here is regarding the distribution of allowed states over energy. So this y-axis is your energy. Okay, so in specific it's electron energy, to be specific. Okay, and if you look at the valence band, we already have seen how these valence band and conduction band has been created because of this atomic separation. And in the valence band, we have total 4n states, right? 4n states are available in the valence band, and all 4n states are occupied with electrons. So 4n states, 4n electrons. So 4n means n is the number of electrons. Oh, sorry, n is the number of atoms in this case. Why number of atom? Because for each atom, we have 4 states available in the valence band. I repeat, for each atom, we have 4 states available in the valence band and 4 states available in the conduction band. In total, 8 states. And for each atom, we have 4 electrons in the system, in the valence band. 4 electrons in the valence band, or you can say 4 valence electrons, or you can say in the outer orbitals. Okay, so we have 4n for n atomic or n atom system, the number will be 4n. Available states in the valence band will be 4n, and the number of electrons in the valence band would be 4n. So all the states are occupied. That I already have discussed in my previous lectures. Now in this case, if we take the example of silicon, so you have 5 into 10 to the power 22 atoms per centimeter cube. If you consider a centimeter cube area, the total number of atoms available for silicon is 5 into 10 to the power 22. So how many states will be there? The number of states will be in the valence band I am talking about. Okay, in the valence band, the number of states will be 4 into the number 5 into 10 to the power 22. That is n in this case, because it is n atom system. Per centimeter cube, the number of available states will be 4 into 5 into 10 to the power 22. This 5 into 10 to the power 22 is the number of atoms per centimeter cube. Okay, so this is the number of states available. So you can understand, so many states are available. It's a huge number, right? It's more or less 20 into 10 to the power 22, or you can say 2 into 10 to the power 23. So 10 to the power 23 states are available per centimeter cube. It's a huge number. Okay, Now let us see how these states are distributed in the valence band or say in the conduction band. So for that purpose, we have taken this plot wherein the x-axis shows the number of states, which is also known as density of states, NE. And as we are taking the concentration of atom per centimeter cube in consideration, so the density of states function unit would be per centimeter cube per electron volt. Okay, because when we say the number of states available, we always consider an interval of energy. Okay, so that's why the unit of energy also will come in the picture. So that one has to remember. In this case, the unit will be per centimeter cube electron volt. That is per centimeter cube per electron volt. Okay. Now, if you look at the distribution of states in the valence band between EV and EB, it will be something like this. Okay. Now, if you want to find out the total number of states in the valence band, what you do? You take a small fraction, that is D, in this region, and then integrate the entire function over this range EB to EV. So in this case, as I have said, for silicon the number of states will be equal to 4 into 5 into 10 to the power 22 per centimeter cube. We are considering per centimeter cube. Okay, so this is how you calculate the number of states. And in this case, we are only interested in the edge region, because whatever distribution is there in the bulk or whatever distribution is there below the edge is not of that interest. As far as this particular course is concerned, will be not of that interest. The other states below the edge, we will be mostly discussing in the edge part. Okay. So here I have magnified the image from EB to EV, and we only take the distribution near the edge, and the nature of the function in this case is parabolic. In fact, we take a parabolic approximation while decide this function. Okay, similarly, in case of conduction band, you will find that near the edge the nature is parabolic. However, the nature of the curve in case of conduction band will not be same as the valence band. It might be something else, but we are not interested in it. We only will take the edge part, which is parabolic in nature. So the function will look like NE is equal to A1 into root E minus EC, where A1 is a constant. We will discuss what that constant is. In case of valence band also, the NE, that is the density of states, will be equal to A2 into root EV minus E. Okay, here A2 is another constant. So the value of A1 and A2 will be as follows, as it is given: 8 root 2 pi mn to the power 3 by 2 divided by h cube, where mn is the effective mass of electron, and in this case mp is the effective mass of hole, right? So this is the value of A1 and A2, and as I have said, that the nature of the function may not be same as the nature of function in the valence band. The nature of function in conduction band may not be same as the nature of function in valence band. However, near the edge, both will be of same type. Okay, that is where we are more interested. We won't see or we won't explore anything beyond this edge. This is currently not our interest. Okay. Now, as I have said, that a fraction of available states only will be occupied at any energy level at any temperature. And that particular thing, I already have said this while I was introducing the band, energy band model, that the third point, that only a fraction of available states will be occupied at any energy at any temperature, at a temperature, particular temperature. When I say at any energy, I mean at an interval of d, okay? Otherwise it doesn't make sense. You always should consider a small interval of d around that energy, okay? Now this particular fraction is given by Fermi Dirac function, which is FET, which is denoted by FET, is equal to 1 by 1 into exponential E minus EF by KT, where EF is Fermi level. This particular value is known as Fermi level EF. Now, let us see what is FET if E is equal to EF. If this is the case, what will be the value of FET? See, if E equal to EF, this particular term will become 0. Then exponential 0 is 1, the value will be half. Okay. And now, secondly, if T is equal to 0, what will be the value? Now, if T is equal to 0, there are two different cases. One is if E is greater than EF. If E is greater than EF, then this value is positive. Then positive value divided by 0 is kind of infinity. Then exponential infinity is infinity. Then 1 by infinity is 0. So your FET will be is equal to 0. However, if your E is less than EF, then this particular term will be negative, and then T is 0, that means E exponential minus infinity, E to the power minus infinity is 0, so 1 by 1 plus 0 is 1, your FET will be equal to 1. So these are the two cases that are very important. Okay, so now we will see how the function looks like if we plot it. Okay, so as it is shown over here, you have energy in the y-axis and the FET function in the x-axis. So FET is equal to half when your energy is equal to EF. So one point we already have seen, if your E is equal to EF, the plot will go through this point where the fraction FET is equal to half, right? And then if you plot the entire function, it will look like the red one as it is shown over here. Okay. Now, the next thing is, what if we change the temperature? If you see the heading of the previous slide, we have said that the fraction of available states, that is FET, at any energy E for temperature T. Now, what if we vary the temperature? That means in that case, your plot also will vary. One example I already have given, if T equal to 0, what if the temperature is equal to 0? If the temperature is 0, FET is 0 if E is greater than EF. So FET, that is this one will be 0 for E greater than EF. So the plot will be something like this, right? Then for E less than EF, this value is 1, right? So for E less than EF, this value is 1. So the plot is like this. This is at T equal to 0, and this is at a temperature T equal to say T1. Okay, so this is the function when you plot it. Now in this case you can see that your energy is in the y-axis, so purposefully I kept the y-axis as energy, because in band model you will find the y-axis is energy all the time, as you can see in the models that I have shown. Your y-axis is always energy, right? So in this case, if you keep the y-axis energy, this will help you to understand the entire thing more easily. However, in different books you may find that the fraction or the function Fe is in the y-axis and the energy E is in the x-axis. Generally this is the case, your dependent variable should be likewise. So if you look at the function, E is in the right hand side, so definitely you should put energy as x-axis and the function itself in the y-axis as per the convention. However, I have shown it here in this way so that understanding becomes much easier when we go in the next discussion. However, even if you change it, in this case the plot will look like this. So if you increase the temperature, say if you increase the temperature to T2, you will find the plot is becoming a bit more flat. So what does this indicate? So if you take any energy beyond EF, you will find that carrier concentration or the fraction that is filled with electron is increasing, which is true, right? If you increase the temperature beyond EF, your states should get filled, and below EF it is actually decreasing. So this is how it is going down. However, in this case it is going up. So what does that mean? The electrons from this side, electrons from below EF is actually getting transferred to above EF. So there is a transfer of electron from low to high energy states if you increase the temperature. That is what you should see. Okay, so it is just this what is getting reflected. Okay, now how do you define this Fermi energy, which is E suffix F? Okay, this is E suffix F. So there are two ways you can define this Fermi energy. One is the energy below which allowed levels are occupied. So Fermi energy or Fermi level is the energy below which all allowed levels are occupied at T equal to 0 Kelvin. So this is T equal to 0 Kelvin, and you can see below EF everything is occupied because Fe is equal to 1, and above EF all are unoccupied at T equal to 0 K. And secondly, Fermi energy is the energy at which exactly half of the available states are occupied. So this is the Fermi energy EF. So at any energy, whatever the energy is, you will find that this particular state is half filled. Okay, that's why it is written Fermi energy is the energy at which exactly half of the available states are occupied for T greater than 0 Kelvin. Now, there is an approximation which is also very important, which is known as Boltzmann approximation. And Boltzmann approximation is valid when E minus EF is either greater than 3kT, or you can write E minus EF by kT is greater than 3, or E minus EF by kT is less than 3. Okay, so it's like either this particular value is more than 3kT or less than minus 3kT. Okay, this is the E minus EF term in the Fermi level. Okay, in the Fermi Dirac function, this is where the E minus EF is in the entire function. Now, if E minus EF is more than 3kT, this E minus EF is more than 3kT, then the entire function will reduce to 1 by exponential E minus EF by 3kT. Why? Because this value will become significantly bigger than 1. So you can ignore 1. This will become 1 by this. So this is exponential minus E minus EF by kT. And if it is less than 3kT, what will become? What will be the case? If it is less than minus 3kT, that is this, in this case, you will find that this particular term is significantly less, very, very less than 1. In such a situation, you can use this approximation where 1 by 1 plus x can be approximated as 1 minus x if x is much, much less than 1. This is what the case is for E minus EF less than 3kT, and the same if you apply in the function, this will become 1 minus exponential E minus EF by kT. So both, in both the cases, the function gets simplified. That's why in many cases you will find that you can use the Boltzmann approximation and the calculation will become much simpler. Okay, and if you plot it, both Fermi-Dirac and Boltzmann approximation, the Fermi-Dirac is the blue one in the middle as shown over here. However, the red one is showing the Boltzmann approximation. So from this 3kT above and below the EF, this is what your EF is. So above and below 3kT, the function will start changing. Okay, so this is how the Boltzmann approximation will look like. So this particular approximation is important in order to simplify many calculations. Okay, so one of the major difference in the assumption is, in case of Boltzmann approximation, many electron can take a single energy state, which was not the case in case of Fermi Dirac. Okay, however, this approximation will help us in simplifying different calculations. Okay, so now let us calculate Ni again using the discussion that we had just now. We already have calculated Ni in a previous slide using this probability, if you remember, and we established why the function, you know, this log Ni versus 1 by T is linear. In this case, also you can calculate Ni, which is intrinsic concentration, or you can also define it as the number of electrons in the conduction bed at any temperature. Okay, whatever is the concentration of electrons in the conduction band at any temperature will be defined as intrinsic concentration. And we know that any into dE is the total number of states available in the interval dE, right? Even in previous case, if you see here, we have taken the d fraction and then integrated it over EB and EV range. EV to EV. If you integrate the entire function over this range, you will get total number of states, right? So here also, if you consider only DE interval, then the total number of states are any into D, right? And then you have the fraction that is occupied, and it is given by FET, that is Fermi Dirac statistics. So if you multiply both of them and integrate the same thing over EC to ET, that means over the conduction band, then you will get the value of NI. Now if you draw it, so this is your energy, and the function will be something like this near the edge, and your Fermi Dirac statistics will be something like this, right? Although we don't know where this Fermi energy is, because it depends on the Fermi energy, right? But things will be similar to this, okay, which I have magnified over here. So this is your EC, and then this is the function any. In the any, you can consider this DE section. So any DE will give you the total number of states in that particular region, and then the concentration will be decided based on the fraction occupied, which is FE into T, which is this function, which is Fermi Dirac function. So you will find the NI plot will be something like this, the shaded area, right? Now if you do this integration, you will find this area. So this is what you are looking for. So if you put the values of the NE and FET in the equation, you will get an equation like this, right? Where we already have taken parabolic density of state approximation. Now let us apply two more approximation. One is ET tends to infinity. Why we will apply ET tends to infinity? Because your FET function is already zero before ET. Now even if you take it till ET, or you may take it till infinity, it doesn't make sense, right? I mean, it will not create a difference. Even if you take till ET, or if you take till infinity, this will not make a difference, right? Although this makes sense that you can replace ET with infinity, because well before ET, your function is zero. So you can consider this upper limit as infinity, which will help us to get rid of one variable. Again, the calculation will become easier. And then you can apply Boltzmann approximation as well in this case. Now if you do this, you will find the expression gets reduced to this, which is 2 into 2 pi mn kt divided by h square whole to the power 3 by 2 exponential minus ec minus ef divided by kt, and this is the expression for NI. That's why I said energy band model will give you a quantitative analysis. Now if you put the values of all these things, you'll get a value for NI. Now remember, this particular equation is under the following approximation, where you replaced ET with infinity. As I've said, physically that doesn't make any difference. Then you have taken Boltzmann approximation, that is the entire calculation is either beyond 3 kT or below minus 3 kT, E minus EF value. That I already have discussed in here. You can take on, I mean, the Boltzmann approximation is valid only for these two conditions. So you have already considered that these two conditions are satisfied in this calculation. and then you have taken parabolic density of states approximation that I already have put here. Okay, so this is the equation for NI. Okay, so in the next class also we will discuss few more concepts.